All right, to make old-fashioned cornbread stuffing, you need to start out with some cornbread. So we're going to use some Jeffy here. Boy, that looks good. What do you think? Is it ready? Mm-hmm. Taste it and let's see. Good enough. Okay, out of the back side of this old turkey, or maybe the front side or wherever, find the giblets and the neck and cook those up. There's the giblets cooking up. These are also awaiting the cornbread, which is also baking at the moment. A big onion is another ingredient, along with a can of mushrooms. Okay, got the onion chopped up. Mushrooms are open. A bag of celery over here, fixing to cut that up. Nice little piece of celery here that Grandma's gonna chop up. Chop, chop, chop. Grandma always has to sharpen her knife on a coffee cup or something. Also the giblets. If you don't have enough, you could buy gizzards, livers, and so forth and cook those. The old turkey neck, had to turn it down a little bit there. It was kind of boiling over a little bit, so just have to keep an eye on these things. Okay, I see she's added another onion and another cup of mushrooms. So we got celery, mushroom, onion, giblets, cornbread. All right, now we're into the carrots. So we are going to have carrots, mushrooms, celery, onion, cornbread, giblets. Grandma's little tiny fingers. Boy, I'm telling you, this cornbread sure does smell good here. We're getting ready to mix all the ingredients. All right, working on the giblets. Tearing all the meat off of it and chopping up all the good stuff. Well, I was told to buy this chicken broth to make this dressing, but here's the broth that's left over from the giblet, so Tuit says she's going to use that instead. Well, this smells good. There's carrots and celery and mushrooms and onions, and mix in the giblets and the cornbread, which is setting over here, and add the broth, and we're about ready. Cornbread. Gotta make sure you got a bigger bowl here for all these ingredients. It's gonna be a lot of stuffing. All right, she's gonna add the broth, and then we're gonna put it in this big old roaster pan here and bake it. Salt and pepper also should be added as per your flavor. All right, now she's coming up with two eggs to add in here with the salt and the pepper. And boy, I'm telling you, that looks good enough to eat right there. It just ain't baked yet. Smells so good already. She's added a little garlic powder also in there. I'm telling you, that thing looks good enough to eat already. And how long are you going to bake this?
Bake until it's brown.
Until it's brown. Pan's really too big, but that is a bunch of dressing right there. Sure does look good. This thing is baking at 250 right now. I actually turned it down from 300 or what, 350. And I'm going to turn it up a little bit and let it brown some more.